Hello friends, let us know what Jimmy has to say about the book The Glass Menagerie by Tennessee Williams. Tennessee Williams, along with Eugene O'Neill, Arthur Miller, and Edward Elby, is regarded as one of the greatest of American dramatists. His 25 plays combine a rare lyrical intensity, haunting loneliness, and hypnotic violence, and are occupied with the pathos of human failure. Persistently concerned with women characters, the play focuses attention on the inner life, the psychology of adjustment necessitated by the impingement of a harsher reality, and acquire a morbid quality. The Glass Menagerie, Williams' first great artistic success, is based on a short story named Portrait of a Girl in Glass and a screenplay, The Gentleman Caller, he had written earlier. The play was not expected to be a success when it opened on December 26, 1944 in Chicago, as the nation's fortune in World War II and the icy weather engaged the attention of the American theater-goers. However, the play elicited reviews that made it an astounding success and laid the foundation for Williams' remarkable rise. Commenting on the sudden success that the play fetched him, he wrote in an essay, "I was snatched out of oblivion and thrust into sudden prominence, and from the precarious tenancy of furnished rooms about the country I was removed to a suite in a first-class Manhattan hotel." The play is autobiographical, as are most of his plays. All the characters find echoes in Tennessee Williams' life. Edwina, Williams' mother, is hopeful and demanding Amanda. Rose is the frail and shy Laura, whose nickname Blue Roses refers directly to Williams' real-life sister. And Cornelius is the absent father with whom he had a complicated relationship. Williams was actually employed in a shoe factory for 2 years in St. Louis, and there actually was a disastrous evening with only gentleman caller who ever came to Rose. Thomas was also Tennessee Williams' real name, and the name Thomas meant twin making, Tom, the surrogate for Williams. He is the audience's eye into the Wingfield situation. His dilemma forms the central conflict of the play, and he focuses a painful choice between responsibility for his family and living his own life. The play is filled with lyrical symbolism. The Glass Menagerie, in its frailty and delicate beauty, serves as a symbol for Laura. She is oddly beautiful and, like her glass animals, fragile and easy to destroy. The fire escape is mostly and closely linked to Tom's character and to the theme of escape. Laura stumbles on the escape, while Tom uses it to get out of the apartment and into the outside world. He goes down the fire escape one last time at the end of the play, and he stands on the landing during his monologues. His position there figuratively exemplifies his position between his family and the outside world, between his responsibility and the urge to lead his own life. Being a memory play, Williams' own description, the theme of memory is crucial. For Amanda, memory is a kind of escape. For Tom, the older Tom who narrates the event of the play, memory is a room without a door. For he is still bewildered with memories of the sister he abandoned years ago. The lead motif of escape provides the play with a structure, as every character seeks flight and escape, some literally and some metaphorically. The Glass Menagerie is remarkable for the expressionist technique it uses, as it takes liberties with the stage conventions and makes use of both traditional devices like music and modern devices like slide projections to dramatize compelling emotional situations. Termed the plastic theater, with an emphasis on the representation of reality, the technique represented a formidable new force on the American stage. In the preface to one of the editors of the play, he throws light on the technique he used. Being a memory play, The Glass Menagerie can be presented with unusual freedom of convention. Because of its considerably delicate, or what we say, tenuous material, expressionism and all other unconventional techniques in drama have only one valid aim, and that is closer approach to truth. The Glass Menagerie is built upon more than the heartrending plot of illusion and frustration in the lives of common people. By deepening the losses of individuals hinting at social and even spiritual catastrophe, William imparts the play with a heightened level of significance. The life of illusion is not confined to Wingfield's alone. As Tom says, the huge middle class of America was matriculating in a school for the blind. The social background of the play acquires tremendous importance. Amanda's anxieties are in large part of economic and money is behind many of her illusions. Some of his well-known plays are A Streetcar Named Desire, which won him a Pulitzer Prize, Cat on the Tin and Roof, Summer in Smoke, The Rose Tattoo, and Camino Real. And this was it, guys. If you liked the video and the book analysis, kindly hit to the like and subscribe icons.